Right, because I thought him and the council was in it together. Yeah. And they're not, mate.
No.
The council's had him right over a few times.
Yeah, yeah. He's no mug, the doctor.
He's no mug, no. But when the council went into it with him, the council promised him this, that and the other, and they've not delivered.
No, again.
Again, again.
But they'll deliver swearing cups on the keys, on the docks.
On the docks, oh yes, they'll pass that one through. Oh yes, they can pass that through. Well, or they can try and rush secretly get underhand dealings through.
I've always respected.
You can have all this ground on Vimpso Gardens, but you don't have to give us any money.
Yeah.
Envelope in the back pocket.
And the Black Horse on the Crescent. Hey,
envelope in the back pocket.
Yeah. I've always respected the doctor, me, because he took on there a challenge with Salford. You know how Salford used to get massive fans.
He didn't know nothing about rugby league, and he sort of wrong advice. Well,
he's a friend of Eamon McMahon, isn't he? Which is the St. Helens chairman. Yeah. Give over now, you're getting on my nerves.
Right, but he didn't have, he sort of wrong advice, and he admitted that.
Yeah.
And I thought, I've got to respect him here.
Yeah, definitely.
I had to respect him because he was man enough to admit that. He bought the wrong players. He tried to buy instant success, and it doesn't come like that. But now it's coming. You look at our team now, and we're no pushovers, are we?
No, well, we've started off well, haven't we? That's the thing.
Is that another thing? Is that another thing why the RFL are trying to do it? We don't want Salford in the top four. You know, because when you think about it, we played Wigan, right? We was unlucky to lose. We was unlucky to lose against Warrington. We battered St. Helens. Yeah. We battered Widnes.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Let's have a think about this.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing, isn't it? The doctor's obviously ruffled a few feathers within the RFL. And you know what? Good to him. Good on him, because
they need shaking up.
I used to think that the RFL was like us.
Yeah,
like me and you, normal, ordinary people.
Not me.
But the older I get, and the wiser I become, the more I analyse what's being said and what's being done. And I honestly think that these people that are in there, they're playing into the hands of the bigger clubs all the time.
Yeah.
There is no level playing field.
There's not a level playing field. There's a top four. It's always been that. And Salford's breaking into that.
And they don't like it. No, they don't. They don't.
They don't like it. They've seen what's happening.
Well, I think the doctors are right. I think he's good for the game.
I think he's good for
Salford. Not just for Salford, but good for the game.
It's good for Salford. I bet all the other fans wish they'd had him.
Well, he comes up with some really sensible things, like this marquee signing.
Yeah. Imagine if Salford had Sam Burgess. Imagine how much he'd put on that game.
Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt.
Them crowds would go from 5,000 to 8, 9 overnight.
I bet you'd have to pay him 15, 20 grand a week, wouldn't you?
What?
Sam Burgess.
20 grand a week?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably more.
That's £1 million a year, that.
Probably more, mate.
But this undisclosed signing, this marquee signing thing, doesn't come on the book, does it?
No. I'd have him tomorrow, would you?
Of course.
I'll tell you what. And you know what? I'd probably let his brothers come as well.
Yeah, yeah. Four of them
there, didn't they? Yeah. I get them in the team as well.
he had it bad in rugby union, didn't he?
He was a scapegoat, wasn't he? Because we never won the World Cup, they made him the scapegoat. And that's what I like, these Hooray Emrys.
Well, not people...
Tick and pass, I call that game.
Yeah.
Fucking tick and pass.
That's what happens with people at the top. It's the same as the RFL.
Yeah,
sorry, you know, it's crazy. But I'm glad the doctor's in there. I'm glad he's ruffling feathers.
Oh, and we're glad we're supporting them nowadays, aren't we?
And if they take 20 points off us, then they're a joke.
Well,
Wigan have done it twice.
In 2007, Wigan got charged with exactly the same thing. Four points.
2 points, wasn't it?
4 points.
What was it? Four points.
4 points. So you can take 4 points off us, because we'll only get them back off when we beat somebody home and away. Yeah, Leeds home and away. So it doesn't matter to us. No. Take them off us. We are Salford. We don't care.
Yeah. We kick one, you kick us all.
Kick us all, yeah. Kick us all. You might rob us out of the title this year. You might rob us out of a grand final place, but you know what? We'll go to Wembley and win that instead.
Yeah, correct.
Do you know what I mean? Keep the faith.
Everybody in that league now
knows,
worrying about Salford.
Salford don't have to go. They don't. We're no easy touch no more.
No.
We proved that against Warrington.
And it's taken us since the 70s when we were good.
To get back to being good, and we're back there now.
Well, let's not...
No, I say we was. We've played top teams and we've not looked mugs.
Let's not jump the gun too early, you know what I mean? I think we're still going to take a season or two more yet.
But we're there. We're there.
It's on a scale of improvement, it's massive from
us. Massive, absolutely fantastic. And I think, you know, so Ian Watson and the Tim Sheens.
Yeah.
And Q Cash.
I see Jim.
And Kukesh as well.
Yeah, definitely. I see Jim Mills. Remember Big Jim Mills?
Yeah, he's played for Wigan.
He had a tweet out. I don't know if he was tweeting, but he said, why was Tim Sheens giving the pre-match team talk in the changing rooms? Will that not cause problems between him and Watson in the end?
I think they work in cahoots, don't they?
Of course they do.
He must be. But you got to remember, Tim Sheens was the Australian coach.
He's no mucks.
So he's bringing their ideas.
He knows the score.
He knows. Salford don't give in no more.
Yeah.
When Wellington went 12-6 up against us, I was dreading it, mate. I was dreading it. But no, we come back. We fought. We had passion.
We put 24 points past them, didn't we?
We had passion. And if you see that team going out there and they're playing with passion, you can't ask for nothing else as a fan.
No, you can't.
You can't ask for nothing else, mate. I'm happy with that.
Yeah.
Okay, we lost with a last second drop goal. And I did put some expletives on my Facebook saying the B word.
Well, you know what, Si? You know what? On a lot of average over the season, things even themselves out.
It's a massive improvement.
Of course it is.
Massive.
So if Warrington would have come to that place and dicked us at one point.
Yeah.
And have done in the past. Yes. You know what I mean?
No more. No one comes to our backyard and takes a mickey no more.
No, do they?
Not in our backyard.
And you know what? To get beat by Wigan by only 4 points.
With a disputed try.
Of course.
And it was two knock-ons and he was in touch.
Well, you know, that's...
By the by.
That's just smacks of...
That's the RFL making these decisions. But
well,
still.
That try was never grounded anyway, was it? He was held up by his own arm, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And the referee gave it.
I think
he needed just what to be on TV, that ball.
He went like that, the ref, when he gave the try. He looks away. He went like that, mate. He looks away. Because I've studied the video.
Right.
He pointed at the ball and he looks away.
Right. Was he looking at his linesman or anything like that?
No, he pointed at it straight away. He was in touch. The corner flag was smashed to bits.
Yeah, but the corner flag, you can touch the corner flag.
As long as your body's not in touch.
Yeah.
Right, but that corner flag was smashed to bits.
Yeah.
It wasn't straight, it was not battered.
Yeah, but if his feet weren't off, if his feet were off the ground, it's a try, isn't it?
I covered this last week with Dennis.
You know,
I don't want to go over ground, but there's no way it was a try. End of.
But it's a certain talking point for Monday anyway. I'm sure he'll bring this up. Monday show.
Right, we've got a special request. What is it? It's the fall.
It's the fall.
It's
the
very on the
for Kev Reed this.
Oh, is it?
I didn't know Kev listened to it. And I'm not sure if it's for his birthday or for someone's birthday anyway.
Yeah.
I know it's Mother's Day tomorrow and all.
So we'll put Mr. Pharmacist on.
I'm sure he'll like this.
I'm sure everyone likes the old chemist now and again, don't they?
Oh, absolutely. And chemicals.
Mr. Pharmacist, you helped me out today in your usual lovely way. Oh, Mr. Pharmacist, I insist that you give us a repayment. Mr. Pharmacist, dear pharmacist, won't you please? Mr. Pharmacist,
Mr. Fall and Mr. Farms is going out there to a Kev Reed. And if it's your birthday, Kev, happy birthday, pal. Or whoever's birthday you put it on
I'll
for.
I'll tell you whose birthday it is today.
Who's?
JB Barrington's.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, yeah. So if you're listening tonight, JB, happy birthday, mate. Yeah. I'm probably blooded, aren't you, mate? I've seen some of your pictures on Facebook earlier and he was looking a tatter.
So I'm a little bit inebriated.
Inebriated, yes.
Right, well, we're going to have to push this link now because we're coming to the end of the show. So right. What I want to do is I want to push some of the T-shirts.
Yes,
so.
If you want to see a picture of me and Coy, get on the Sounds of Salford Facebook page on the main picture, isn't it, mate? You can see us with the T-shirts on. If you want a T-shirt, get in touch with us.
And they're a tenner each and they're good value, they're good quality T-shirts. Don't put them in the dryer, though. And just... Help us push it with our station and our programming costs and stuff like that. And the tenner, and when you get one, to make sure you take your picture of it wherever you are and get it posted.
And it'll go on the Sounds of Salford Facebook page, won't it, mate?
And certainly when we get our website up and running.
Yes, we'll have a picture of just the Sounds of Salford T-shirt page.
Yeah.
The website's nearly due. It's nearly ready. I've had a couple of quick looks at it and the basics are there, but it's not completely finished, so...
Well, it won't take long, will it?
No, it won't take long. Right, on that note, if you've enjoyed what you've listened to, you've listened to the Sounds of...
Salford!
If you haven't, you've listened to...
Radio Tallinn.
Right, so do us a massive favour on the streets of Salford tonight.
Enjoy yourself and keep safe.